I'm James, a knee, foot, and ankle specialist, and we're going to talk you through all of the conditions that can cause pain in the outer ankle, what might cause them, the symptoms that they may present, and some tips on how you can manage them. If you're walking down the street and you turn your ankle outwards on an uneven surface or on the edge of a curb, that's the most common cause of outer ankle injury, and that's typically a lateral ankle sprain. So, as you can see from the diagram, we've got three main ligaments on the outer ankle, the ATFL, the CFL, and the PTFL, and they help to protect your ankle from turning outward excessively, and they help to give you some awareness of what your foot is doing in space. If you roll your ankle with speed and force, it can cause a tear of these ligaments, and the most commonly torn is the ATFL. In severe cases, you might hear an audible pop or feel a clicking noise, and this is often a sign of a significant tear or rupture to the ligament. In milder cases, you might roll the ankle, not really feel much pain, and then you start to get a dull ache later on in the day. Or in severe cases, you feel that pop, you get immediate onset of pain and swelling, and sometimes you're unable to weight bear. The swelling typically presents on the outer ankle, often in the shape of a tennis ball. It can become bruised within 24 hours. It's not uncommon for that bruising to seep down towards the toes as a result of gravity. These conditions are typically managed with taping, balance, strengthening, and stretching exercises. In most cases, they can resolve on their own, but it's not usually as simple as a straightforward ligament sprain for most of these, and we'd always recommend having an assessment with a physical therapist or podiatrist. As a result of the same mechanism of injury, you can also tear some of the tendons on the outer ankle. So these are known as the peroneal tendons. We typically have three of these that run along the outside of the ankle, attaching onto the outside of the foot or underneath the foot. They help to turn the foot outwards, but they also help to stabilize your ankle as you walk or as you run. If you sprain your ankle and you turn it out rapidly, it can stretch those tendons as well as the ligaments that we mentioned before, and it can cause a tear of those peroneal tendons. So what we could see in the worst case scenario is a avulsion tear where the tendon pulls off its attachment on the fifth metatarsal, so it pulls off a fragment of bone leading to a fracture. Those usually have immediate onset of pain, inability to weight bear, and we typically manage them by putting them into a boot, but they often need a surgical opinion. Another cause of peroneal injury is that you get longitudinal tear of the peroneal tendon. So most tears go horizontally across the tendon, but in a longitudinal tear it goes lengthways, and these are often very difficult to manage because the tendon struggles to repair, as every time you move the foot, the tear opens and closes. Another common cause of pain in that area is peroneal tendinopathy. So we have peroneal tendons that run down the outside of the ankle and they attach on to the base of that fifth metatarsal, so the base of the pinky toe. If that tendon becomes overloaded, again through running or impact activities, it becomes what we classify as tendinopathic, and that results in change to the structure of the tendon itself. So it has a different pattern of pain than that of a fracture in terms of when you exercise, it's often worse at the start, improves as you get going, and then it's worse again afterwards, whereas with a fracture, the pain is gradually increases the more impact or force that you apply through it. Finally, sticking with the peroneal tendons, they sit in a little groove as they run on the outer ankle, so just below the bony aspect of your ankle, and there's a little bit of tissue that goes on the outer layer to help keep them inside the groove. Sometimes when you get a significant ankle sprain, you can tear that little bit of tissue that holds them within that groove, and you get peroneal tendon subluxation. Symptoms of that is that when you move your ankle inward or outward, or sometimes when you're walking, running, or hopping, you hear an audible click or pop as the tendon moves in and out of that groove. Sometimes it can be pain-free, other times it can just be more irritable due to the audible noise, and some cases it can be painful as the tendon rubs off the bone, it can irritate the tendon somewhat. Another common condition on the outer ankle is a condition called sinus tarsi syndrome. So there's a little gutter that runs underneath your ankle that we talked about with the peroneal subluxation. Within that you've got tendons, ligaments, nerves, blood vessels, and sometimes if you have an unstable ankle or you have a sudden movement that turns the ankle outward, it pinches on that groove, pinches the tissues and nerves and blood vessels within it, causes inflammation and irritation. It's not necessarily a condition in itself, but very much symptoms of an unstable ankle or trauma that's occurred to the joint before this. It typically results in a dull ache that sits on the outside of your ankle. It can persevere after exercise, and it is typically worse with impact exercise. If you have a history of ankle sprains, what you might find is that the ankle sprain recovers, but you're left with this irritation within the sinus tarsi, and that results in this kind of dull ache state that persists over a long period of time. And that's another key reason to have an assessment after you have a lateral ankle sprain, because it helps to stop secondary conditions like a sinus tarsi syndrome. Finally, moving on to one of the last complications of a lateral ankle sprain, you can sprain some of the lesser known ligaments, such as the bifurcate ligament. So that helps to stabilize the ankle slightly further down than where you would see a typical ATFL injury. And it's a less common but often misdiagnosed injury. So most clinicians might look at a typical ankle sprain, assess the ATFL ligament, work through the rehab process, but miss out on the bifurcate ligament sprain, and it often coexists alongside a fracture to the anterior process of the calcaneus. So that's the attachment site of the ligament. And in that type of injury, the ligament pulls off a fragment of the bone, resulting in an avulsion fracture. And this can be one of the reasons why you get prolonged pain slightly further down the ankle after you've had a lateral ankle sprain. Other causes of outer ankle pain includes subtalar joint osteoarthritis. So as you can see from the diagram, the subtalar joint helps to turn the ankle inward and outward. Due to a history of trauma, previous instability of the ankle, or just general changes over time, we can get arthritis in the joint. Typically presents without a specific mechanism of injury. Often we see stiffness first thing in the morning or after we get up from sitting for a period of time. It can be a bit generally achy and results in a reduced range of motion of the ankle joint. And as we try to do increased activity, the pain often increases alongside it. So not a very pleasant injury overall. So the final cause of outer ankle pain may be a tarsal coalition. We know they exist in about 13% of cases, and it's normally the result of when we're born, the bones don't separate, typically the calcaneal navicular joint, and as a result, they're not as mobile as you might like them to be, and they can become painful from overload or from a lateral ankle sprain. So hopefully we covered most of the conditions and causes of your potential pain. If you found the video helpful, please like and subscribe to the channel, and if you've got any questions, please leave them in the comment section below.